Hey, it's Maddie getting ready to talk to Yorgan De Castro ahead of UFC 249. Yorgan, how are you, my friend?
Very good, man. Very good. I'm ready to go. Girl.
Now, you just got into Jacksonville, correct?
Yes, I got here like a couple hours ago.
I got to know, how's the airport right now? Is it just completely hectic?
No, yes, it was. What we got from Providence was like empty.
Yeah.
But we get to the plane, it was actually like pretty full, 120 people. But everybody with the gloves and mask and sound safety. I mean,
yeah. I hope you had your mask on.
I had my mask. Just take it off right now, but I got my mask on.
Repping the regiment training center now. Is that where you train?
Yes, yes.
Very nice. And I know you're a fan of cross training. So where do you typically like to go to cross train?
I do my sparring sometimes. I lose MMA, Triforce, and down there in Providence. I love it. Yeah, I've been Extreme Couture for this one in Vegas. I mean, I love mixed martial arts about learning. Mm-hmm. And if I can get, and my coach too, they support me for, I mean, they know that the more train I get, the better I become. So, yeah, I like cross training.
I like it too, especially Lozon's MMA. I feel like Lozon's is somewhat of a mecca for New England MMA. Why do you think it's become such a mecca for all of the stars around in New England?
I mean, Joe Luz is a legend. That's what I start. I started over there with him in 2014. So that was my first team. Yeah, and he's a fount of knowledge. So he's been in the game for so long, and he always share with the newcomers. Yeah, and if you can, everybody go around and find a good training session one place. That place is Lozon MMA for sure.
Shout out to Lozon MMA. I love going on Saturdays.
Yes.
So I know that you are Cape Verdean.
Yes.
Do you have a lot of fans on the island?
I do. I'm actually a mix. Born in Cape Verde. I grew up in Portugal. My mom is Cape Verdean and my father is Portuguese. But I do have a lot of fans in Cape Verde.
So you feel well received? You feel, because there's not many Cape Verdeans, you know, in the UFC. So no. You feel well received?
I do feel well received. I mean, they. I feel like all the country's backing me up, and I feel blessed.
I'm glad. And I'm really glad that you feel well-received in Cape Verde, but also in Fall River, Massachusetts. I feel like you are a celebrity status for Fall River, Massachusetts. Why do you think that is? And are you loving this amount of gratitude you're getting from them?
Damn right. I love Fall River, man. I originally moved from Portugal to Brockton, but then I moved to Fall River 4 years ago. The city adopted me. They back me up. Like since then, they take care of me everywhere I go. People love me and they always back me up. And I think the good part is I bring a good positive thing to the city. I mean, I'm a normal guy who work in my daily work and I still fight in the ESPN and the pay-per-view and then I go back to my normal life. So I think that's a lot of people related and I give a lot of people hope.
And speaking of normal life, I know you have a beautiful daughter.
Yeah.
Do you mind talking about your daughter?
Yes. She's now in TikTok. She likes to do TikTok stuff.
Is she going to be TikTok famous?
She want to be famous. She says, first she said, I want to be a YouTuber. Now she said, Dad, I want to be famous, a TikToker. And she's the boss. She's my everything. That's what I do. This I do for her.
If you don't mind my asking, how old is she?
She's six.
She's 6 years old. So that's still on the younger side. Do you let her in to the fighting lifestyle or do you feel like you need to shelter her a little bit?
No, she likes to go to the gym, but when it's regular gym, just lift and do the things, she loves it. But everything when you get contact sport, I've been trying to get into jiu-jitsu, kickbox. She say, no, Dad, I'm a girl. I don't want to do that.
I'm going to sit down with her and I'm going to let her know. She needs to at least know something.
Something, right?
Well, even if she doesn't want to train, what are you hoping that she takes away from the experience of martial arts? I mean, it's going to be a part of her life as long as you're her dad. So what do you hope that she takes away from that mentally?
I'm, that's what I want her to take away. Everything you do in life is going to be hard, going to have ups and downs, but never give up. This is not an easy life as a fighter. Like anything you choose in life to do. It's going to be ups and downs, and that's what I want her to say. It's going to be hard. You're going to have some lows, but don't give up, and in the end, they will all pay off. Everything's going to pay off.
That's sweet. I'm gonna have to go on TikTok and find her. Help her get TikTok famous. But all right, you got a fight coming up, so let's switch gears and head back towards the fight. I understand you started your career as a light heavyweight, and now we're heavyweight. Why did we make that switch?
That was actually my old manager, the one who made that decision, Tyson. He thought that I was a better heavyweight than light heavyweight. My skills will be more. He say since I'm faster, I move good. And he say as a light heavyweight, everybody have the same skill set. Mm-hmm. As a heavyweight, my skill will come up on top. And plus, I'm 32, so he thinks that as a heavyweight, I would do good. Actually, that was pop to him. He's not my manager anymore, but that was one of the things that he did good for me, and that was his choice. And I stick with him. I feel good actually, heavyweight.
Good. I mean, you look great. You look strong. Thank you. Got to talk about this leg kick TKO that you got in the Contender Series, because I feel like you don't really hear that in the heavyweight world, TKO by leg kicks. Is it because you have a kickboxing background?
I do have a kick. That was actually my second guy that I finished with. I finished a guy with a leg kick too in a kickbox match, like I think 2 years ago. Bigger than the last one. I got good kicks. My coach always tell me, man, if I that should be my goal, man. Not my hands, but my kicks. If I should kick more, and okay. I plan on using it a lot Saturday night.
Yeah, absolutely. So that definitely sounds like part of your game plan. I mean, leg kicks are definitely not fun. So that sounds like a solid game plan right there. Now, you're facing Greg Hardy, UFC 249. Now, there is a lot of speculation and a lot of people saying that this fight doesn't belong on the main card. That, you know, it's funny that Cerrone and Pettis aren't on the main card. What do you have to say to those people?
It's crazy, man. We don't have sport for 2 months, and you complain about what position I'm going to be in the card. I mean, just enjoy the fight. I don't pick. I'm pretty sure Greg Hardy didn't pick to be the main card. UFC put in the main card for a reason. I'm going to tell you why the reason. One of us going down, we're going to come swinging. There's a good, open main card. I do respect all the fighters down there. There's a 3 former fighters in the prelims. Former champ, Fabrice Verdun, Anthony Pettis. But it is what it is. I will be happy to fight in this card, period. No matter what my position, main card or open the prelim.
So yeah, I mean, I have no doubt that you're going to be bringing those haymakers. It's
yeah,
going
to
be great.
I'm gonna, for those people who complain, I will say, tune in and see that one of us going down. We're going to come. We're going to meet in the middle of the cage, and we're going to swing. So they're going to be. I think that's it. They're going to be what?
Tune in UFC 249 Saturday night. It's going down. Now, after this weekend, what is the plan for Yorgan De Castro? What do you see yourself in the future and the future in UFC?
I definitely, if everything goes the way I plan and I get the win Saturday, I think I'm going to get a top 15 or top 10 guy next. But I also think I should change a lot of things around me. Not like I have a great coach, great manager, my family support me, but I need to change the approach that I have to the game. I rely on my skills and my power, but I should be working more on my fitness and lose some weight and feel better as an athlete. And I have a different project. I think after this, I'm going to be a totally different animal.
It's always good to evolve, especially in the martial arts world.
Right? Yes. It's hard. It's hard to admit it when you're winning. I'm undefeated. So sometimes you think you're winning, you can get away with stuff. But I know I have work to do, and I'm going to be focused on those.
And that's the ideals of a champion. That's why I'm excited to follow your career. That's wonderful. Now, nice. I'm dying to know my final question. What is the first meal that you will be eating after you win?
First meal is going to be pizza and Corona beer.
Corona. Nice choice.
Or the Blue Moon. I like Blue Moon too. So.
All right. I'll have to remember that. Either Blue Moon or Corona. What kind of pizza?
Pepperoni pizza.
All right. A classic man. I like it. Well, Yorgan, thank you so much for talking with me today. And I wish you all the best. New England is behind you. And I'm very excited to watch you Saturday night.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Anytime.